Hi everyone, my name is Johan and I'm a senior cloud developer advocate working at Microsoft. In this video, we'll see how to configure routing in your static web apps. We'll start from this shopping app example that displays a list of products to the user. First, let's have a look at the project. This shopping app was coded using four different frameworks, as you can see. Here, we'll use the React version, but feel free to use the version you know best and adapt the instructions if needed. We'll start by quickly deploying this app on Azure Static Web Apps. Open the command palette with F1 and search for Create Static Web App. I'll choose Custom as I need to tell that my app is located in the React-App folder. Then for the output folder, Build Works for React. And now my app is being deployed. It will take a few minutes. Meanwhile, we'll have a look at our app using the Static Web App CLI. In the terminal, go to the React App folder and run npm run build, so you build the app. Run the Static Web App emulator with swa start build and open the app in a browser. You can see that the app works fine, I can navigate normally. But what if I refresh the page? Suddenly, I get a 404 error. That's because this app is a single page app and use client-side routing that changes the URL you see at the top. What happens when we hit F5 to refresh the browser is that the browser tries to load the product's URL and the web server search for a matching products.html file and this one does not exist. So, to fix this error, we'll add a routing configuration to our static web app. Now we create a new file called staticwebapp.config.json in the React App folder. And now we'll add a fallback rule telling to rewrite all routes toward our root file index.html. We also need to exclude some file extension here to avoid our images and styling to be rewritten too. Now, if we restart the Static Web App CLI server, we can see that now it's working if we refresh the browser. Now, let's say that you refactored your app and instead of using the products in the URL, the previous page that you had used the root name catalog. You want all the users that already bookmarked the old URL to be redirected to the new products page that you have. You can do that by creating a new routes array in your configuration file. In there, you can specify your route redirection like this. First, you need to tell which route you want to redirect, so here it's catalog. Then you tell it to which URL you want to redirect it to, so here it's product. By default, the redirect will use the 302 status code, meaning that it's only a temporary redirection. But you can override that by adding a status code property. So let's use a 301 code here as it's a permanent redirection. Now if we restart the CLI again, then try to navigate to the old catalog URL, you can see that we are redirected to the products page. There's a lot more that you can do with routing configuration, like adding headers to specify how your images should be cached, for example, or restrict access to some parts of your application to users that are not logged in. But that's something you'll see in the following videos. That's it for this one. See ya!